Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So if you are new to the channel, thank you so much for stopping by. If you like what you see, I'm gonna need you to go ahead and subscribe. You feel me? Now, this is the part two of the series of my, I'll be wanting to call him my boyfriend, but he wasn't really my boyfriend, but I'm gonna just call him my boyfriend. This is part two of the series of me dealing with Stanley, getting rid of him. I think I started talking about Stanley when I first started telling my story time. If you don't feel like going all the way down there looking for the videos, I did make a part one of this series. It's literally going to be the video before this video. Really check that out first and then come back and check this out. I would like to thank you so much for giving me my likes. I liked it. Just give me my money. I was looking at the like ratio, like it's definitely improved, and I mess with y'all for that. I really do, because I'm gonna be real with y'all. The tube, if y'all know, like what app is this? This app is the tube. Y'all, the tube be trying to, I don't know what it is, but the tube be trying to say that my content is inappropriate, and I don't know, like it just be picking up on little things, and it be trying to like not put me on the algorithm. But when you guys like the video, it pushes me back on the algorithm. So for everybody who liked the video, thank you guys so much. I highly appreciate it. Also, be sure to just go ahead and give this video a thumbs up, because we're going to do a part three of this series. I'm going to leave part one in the description box down below. Oh, before we start the story time, hey, look at the subscriber account. We are on the way to 50K. So if you have been watching me and I'm seeing people, because YouTube actually shows returning viewers who haven't subscribed. A lot of people that watch my videos that just have not subscribed. You've been watching me and you have not subscribed. Be sure to hit that subscribe button, because we are on the road to 50K. I'm trying to get to 50K before this year ends. Babe, I'm trying to get to 50K before the middle of December, okay? Like, come on, we can do it, y'all. I was reading the comments, y'all. I was reading the comments and I was just laughing. Like, telling my older stories, like, with guys that I dealt with when I was younger, it just kind of gives the ladies who are in college or in high school, it kind of gives them like a little, kind of shows them what not to do. I don't know, y'all, like when it come to men, I be delusional, I'm not gonna lie. Like when it come to boys, when it come to men, I be delusional. You feel me? So I be wanting to tell these story times so you guys don't be delusional with me. And somebody had commented and was like, Irene, you meant to tell me that you was dealing with Stanley while you was dealing with all these other story times that you told us about in college at the same time. She was like, come here, let me pop you. And when I tell you, I was laughing. If I find a comment, I'm gonna put it somewhere. When I tell y'all, I was laughing so hard when I read that comment, because I really had to think about it. Like, girl, you was just being mad delusional back there. Like, you, like, I'm still a little delulu. I ain't gonna lie, I'm still a little delulu for the men's, but I'm not as delulu as I was in college and high school. Bitch, I was dumb. It's a difference. Now I'm just like, you know, I'm a little intitishy bit delulu. One thing that I have noticed about me now when it comes to guys is that I tend, like, ever since Legion, I know when it's time to go. Like, it don't matter how hard, like, I'm hurt, I might try to spin the block a little bit, but my brain always tells me, Irene, like, this relationship has ran its course, let's go. But when I was younger, I did not understand the power of letting a relationship go and going on about my business. So that is the reason why Stanley always had me hooked. And like I told you guys in all my story times about Stanley, whenever I tried to leave him alone, he would peep it. It's like he was like, his energy was so, like, he was a leech. Like, he had a leeching type of energy. He would like see that I was leaving him, and like he would do little things and like, you know, just do little like weird shit to try to get me to come back to him. Will work, you know what I mean? So let's get straight into it. Now let me give you guys a refresher from the last story time. So if you guys don't know, like I always say, Stanley is this guy that I dated for so many years that played me all them years. Now let's set the scenery. We're in college now, not really dealing with Stanley like that, but I'm dealing with him here and there. Have a little bit of suspicions that he messed with my best friend that I fell out with, but I don't have no proof. It's literally just from my head. I'm just thinking, like, my brain is just telling me, like, he slept with your best friend. I have no proof. Nobody has came and told me that he slept with her. And one thing about the Holy Spirit. I don't know what it is, but the Holy Spirit, when it comes to me and men, it doesn't matter whether I'm reading my Bible. It doesn't matter whether I'm talking to God in that season that I'm dating that guy. God always gonna talk to me about somebody that I am dating. Always. It don't matter what it is. And that's just what it was with Stanley. Like, something just kept saying, like, he slept with her, he slept with her, he slept with her. Then let's fast forward to after he left work, I ended up going to his house, to Pound Town. Next day, went to class, texted him, and he didn't reply. So let's keep it from there. So at this point, y'all, I'm embarrassed, okay? And if any of you guys will say that you're not embarrassed, you'll be a liar. I'm embarrassed. I'm like, oh wow, like, okay, we're doing what we did in high school all over again. Like, we're texting when we feel like, we're calling when we feel like. Okay, like, I understand it now, you know? So I did not get mad or nothing. I was just more so embarrassed. And I was also, if anything, not mad at him, but just mad at the fact that I let him back into my energy and my vicinity and everything again. Like, I was just not happy with that, right? So I just went on about my business. I'm like, I chucked it up to the game. I'm like, all right, cool. Like, you know, you want to play that where you feel like you could text me when you feel like it. Like, you want to play that type of game? Like, let's play that type of game. So I ended up blocking him. I blocked his ass. Just blocked his number. I did not have him on socials at the time to block his socials. So I remember one time, there was like, let's say months had went by, y'all. I had not seen him. I'm gonna say like a month or two went by. I hadn't seen, no. That's not what happened. Let me backtrack. Winter break happened. Now everybody then went home. Now, you know, in college, some people go home, some people stay. It depends on your apartments. I know there's certain apartments at my college where, like, you have to go home. Like, it's not an option. But I didn't stay on campus. So it was either you stay on at your apartment or you go home. I know around that time, I think I did half and half. I think there were some weeks where I went home. There were some weeks where I just stayed up at the school because I don't know. I didn't really see the purpose of me going home fully. This was a specific week where I decided to stay at the school. I ended up getting a call from my little brother. And I'm looking like, why is he calling me? But, you know, I'm not thinking much of it. I'm like, you know, because I'm going to be real. Me and my brother don't really talk like that. Like, if, like, it's not a good thing. But me and my brother have a very much out of sight, out of mind type of relationship. Like, if I don't see my brother, he don't call me. I don't call him. I pray for him. I hope the nigga praying for me. But like, we have like an out of sight, out of mind type of vibe. Like, right now he's in college and he does not call. I mean, he called me literally last week and I was so shocked. I'm like, oh my God, you called me? And he was like, yeah. And I remember I was confronting him one time and I was like, because he talks to his girlfriend like every day, of course. And I remember one time he was talking to her and I grabbed her phone and was like, nigga, you don't call me? And he was like, when you was in college, you didn't call me either. And I was like, the little nigga kind of right, you know. Damn. But I'm big mama. Bitch, you supposed to call your older sibling. Or is the older sibling? That's so odd. Anyways, I'm getting off topic. Just know that my brother don't really call me like that. So to see him calling me was kind of weird. We get on the phone and I'm like, hey, what's up? And mind you, my brother knows about Stanley. Like, my brother knows about Stanley. He doesn't know everything, y'all. Like, he don't know everything, but he knows about Stanley. So he's like, man, I don't know, but Stanley crazy. And I'm just like, what are y'all, like, what? Like, what do you mean? If you guys watch my past videos with Stanley, then you guys would know where I'm going with this. But this part goes into the story, so I have to retell it again for the people who did not see that story time. My brother tells me that he is in the basketball court at gym. At the gym that we go to, he's playing basketball. He says that Stanley comes up to him and was like, hey, are you Irene's brother? Because Stanley, he didn't really talk to my brother like that. But, you know, I used to post my brother and then sometimes he would see my brother, you know. So he comes up to my brother and he's like, hey, are you Irene's brother? And he's like, yeah. And he's like, hey, like, could you tell Irene to unblock me? I've been trying to get in touch with her. I'm one of her good friends. Y'all, when my brother told me that, I was looking like, one of who? One of who? One of her good what? Friends? We are not friends. We ain't even acquaintances. Bitch, I don't like you. So my brother was like, Well, mind you, this not the first time that Stanley has done this. Stanley has done this to my brother a good 3-4 times. I ain't gonna lie. So my brother was like, if y'all friends, why are you blocked? As he should ask. Here comes Stanley. You know, differences and stuff like that. I don't really know. Like, I don't know. But, like, could you please just give me the number? Like, he's literally cutting my brother off, like, on some, like, fuck what you saying. He's like, but could you please just give me her number and see? I need to get in touch with her. Like, she's a good friend of mine. I need to get in touch with her. My brother's like, well, let me ask her if she wants you to have her number again, or to let me ask her if she wants to unblock you. Like, let me ask. No, you don't gotta ask. You don't gotta ask. Like, it's cool. Like, just tell her to unblock me. You don't gotta ask. Just tell her that I said to unblock me, that it's an emergency. My brother's like, okay, I will. And he walked off and he called me when he left the basketball court. So I'm like, hell no, not unblocking that boy. Like, I'm just telling my brother, like, I am not unblocking him. Like, hell no. Like, he made his bed, but she gonna have to die in it. Fuck laying. When you lay in a bed, you get to get up and get out. She gonna have to die in it. Nah, let me stop saying that. That's not good. But I'm like, let me stop saying that. Nah, God forbid. I'm not saying die for real. But I'm like, nah, like, you make that bed, babe. You gotta lay in it. You gotta lie in that bed. Like, no, I'm not unblocking you. I'm not unblocking you. And you not gonna come talk to my brother and speed up the process of me unblocking you. I'm gonna unblock you when I feel like unblocking you. I'm not gonna do it on your time. So me and my brother, we just talking shit on the phone. Like, my brother like, that nigga weird. Like, you coming up to the sibling, you think the sibling finna give you the number just cause the sibling younger. Like, we just talking shit, you know what I mean? We just chop it up, we talk shit. I didn't really tell my brother what he did, but I just told my brother that he just be on bullshit. Like I said, Stanley be on bullshit. I said, Stanley messes with me when he feels like it, and I don't like that. Cause it's like, I actually like you. You know what I mean? Like, I like you. And you just feel like you could just come and go as you please. Like, nah. Like, and this is another thing. Even though I liked Stanley, I didn't like Stanley as much as I did in high school. But when Stanley was doing the same shit that he was doing in high school, it was easier for me to just block him and go on about my business, because I didn't like him as much anymore. So it's like, nah, like, you're not gonna act like you too cool for me. Cause that's always the vibe that Stanley gave in high school. And another thing is, y'all, I was thinking that Stanley was gonna be different in college because, like I said, y'all remember, in high school, no one liked me. No one liked me in high school. Everyone hated me. None of Stanley's friends liked me. They always used to ask him, like, why are you talking to her? So I was thinking, oh, we're in college. Like, stuff is going to be different now because, you know, he doesn't have nobody down his neck about me. He doesn't have anyone interfering with the fact that he likes me. No, like, the nigga, I don't know if it's because I just kept talking to him. He did not care about me not one bit, y'all. He didn't care about me not one bit. And I wasn't here for it. So when my brother called me, it made me even say even more, that number is going to continue to stay blocked. Okay. That number is going to continue to stay blocked. School has now resumed. We're back at school. I'm not even thinking of Stanley, y'all. Like, I'm not thinking of Stanley. I'm dating other guys. I'm talking to other guys. Stanley is not even in my mind. I do think of him here and there when I go to Chick-fil-A and I see him. There were times still that I would go to Chick-fil-A. I will see him. He will see me. We'll make eye contact. It will be nothing. Like, he will look at me. He will look away. I will look at him. I will look away. And we'll just keep it pushing, right? Fast forward to one day, I get an unknown call, and I'm like, who is this calling? Mind you, remember I told y'all back then when I used to block Stanley, he would unknown call me a good 30, 40, 50, 11 times until I unblocked him. But this time that I blocked Stanley, he did not unknown call me when I first blocked him. So my mind is not thinking that this is Stanley that's calling, because I was thinking to myself, Stanley would have been called me a long time ago. You know what I mean? My mind is not thinking that. And like I told you guys before, I was dating and I was blocking niggas left and right. You know what I mean? So I did not know who it was calling me. So I answered the phone and I'm like, yeah, who is this? All I hear is Stanley. And he's saying it low. Nah, nigga, you need to speak up. Like how you was speaking up when you was loudly disrespecting me. So he's like, it's Stanley. I'm like, who? He's like, Stanley. I'm like, yeah, nigga, what you want? Like, what is it? Like, what do you want? He's like, so you just gonna keep me, you just gonna keep me blocked? Like, you just gonna keep me blocked? Like, I don't even feel like that is fair. That is not fair. Like, he just start talking. And I'm like, look, Stanley, I'm not finna play this game with you. I said, you know what you did. I said, you're doing the same thing that you did in high school. You feel like you can come and go as you please. You feel like you can talk to me when you feel like. When you don't want to talk to me, you ignore me. I don't like that. I said, I've been telling you since high school that I don't like that, and I'm not going to do it with you in college. I'm not going to do it with you. He's like, first of all, I answered you back. He said, you want to sit up here and you want to block people and stuff like that? I answered you back. I answered you back. And I'm like, you did not answer me back in a timely manner. He's like, it don't matter. I still answered you back. I still answered you back. And he's like, and by the time I answered you back, the messages popped up green. Like, you didn't even wait a whole 24 hours before you blocked me. I answered you back later on that day. And I'm like, okay, I don't care. I don't care. I don't care. Because when you want that cookie, you be texting quick, fast, and in a hurry. But when we talking about other stuff, you take it 10 hours to respond. Who do you think you are? You know what I mean? So it's like, nah, like, it's cool. Like, you know, I'm beginning to peep that you like me in a lustful manner, but you don't like me. Like, you don't really like me. It's cool. Like, it's cool, you know? But you're not gonna get no more plays. Put it in my head that he's not getting no more cat. Like, he's not getting no more cat. He's not getting no more play because I just begin to peep, like, oh, okay, everything is very lustful with you, you know? I'm telling him that, y'all, like, I'm telling him that. And he's like, that's not true, I like you, that's not true, just lying. He's like, I like you, that's not true, blase, blase. The reason why we didn't work out in high school is because it was your fault, and it's still your fault now. This boy is blaming me, y'all. He's blaming me. So I said, okay, let's talk about why we didn't work in high school. Because, y'all, me and Stanley never sat down and talked about any of our indifferences, any of our problems, anything. Like, we never talked truly about the shit that happened in high school. We never talked about it. We just like let shit happen, stop talking to each other for like a month or a week or however long. He blows up my phone and we're talking again. And when we're talking again, we don't bring up the situation. Like, I didn't used to bring it up, he didn't used to bring it up. Like, it's like we just acted like it just didn't exist. And then we would just be back again, cool. Until, like, he would piss me off again. And then I would bring up the situation from last time. But that's not healthy at all. Because, you know what I mean? Like, you're not really talking about stuff for real. Like, you're really just pushing shit under the rug until mad day again. So I just felt like we never talked about high school. All the stuff that I'm telling y'all now about how I felt like he never defended me. I never got to really tell him that, like, you know, on the phone or in college about how he never defended me in high school. I never got to speak to him about anything. Like, I was, and then the Irene back then, I'm gonna be real with y'all. The Irene back then, I don't know what it was when it came to men that I was dealing with or men that I liked. I wasn't really like, even though I was confrontational in a manner of like cursing and telling them to D-I-E and like throwing stuff. Like, I was confrontational in that type of manner. Like, I didn't know how to communicate, to say the least. I wasn't a good communicator. Like, if you pissed me off, I was just gonna tell you to, you know, stand in front of the nearest train and you know what I mean? Like, just like, I was just gonna tell you that. And I remember my mom always used to be like, can you stop telling people to die? Like, can you stop doing that? But I'll be like, nah, like, the motherfuckers had me fucked up. They need to go see God real quick and talk to God. Like, I'm not telling you to die forever, but bitch, I'm telling you for a quick second, go up to heaven and talk to God and ask God for forgiveness for playing with his child. You know what I mean? Like, that's just how I felt about it. So, yeah. So, and y'all, I don't feel like that now. Like, I've been stopped telling people to D-I-E since Legion, so. And I know somebody gonna watch this video and be like, girl, you was just dating Legion earlier this year. Y'all, bitch, I improved. Bitch, I improved. I haven't told a nigga to die since then. You feel me? I've improved. I just told him that. I'm like, yeah, like, you're not getting no more. Like, we're not doing it no more. It's cool. Like, you know, I'm cool on you. Like, I gotta prove to you to prove that I like you. What do you want me to prove? He said, you see, I'm still messing with you from high school. He said, what do I gotta prove? I said, I don't know, Stanley. I honestly don't know. But, you know, just show me that you like me outside of sex. Like, show me. Like, show me what you know type shit. Show me that you like me outside of sex. And then, like, I'll maybe talk to you again. I said, but up until then, I'm not unblocking your number until I feel like it. Because mind y'all, we still on this unknown call, y'all. So he's like, all right, I get you. So I'm like, yeah. So we get off the phone. Radio silence. I don't hear nothing. I don't see nothing. It was given very much out of sight, out of mind. One day, I just decided to unblock him. I didn't hit him up. He didn't hit me up. I just unblocked him. I was just like, y'all know y'all had that one ex that you always block and unblock, block and unblock. Y'all know. He was that one ex. He's literally been the only guy in my life that I have blocked and unblocked so many times. There's no other guy that I've done this with. So I unblocked him one day and I just went about my business. I'm guessing Stanley was like messaging our iMessage thread until the messages popped up blue one day. So I guess he messaged me and he was like, hey, and I guess it popped up blue. So as soon as it popped up blue, he called me. I'm like, so he called me. I'm like, hey, what's up? Like, weeks have passed by. I'm not mad no more. I don't care, y'all. Let me keep reemphasizing this. I am still dating other people. So it's not like I'm so hyper focused on this one boy. No, like, I'm dating other people. I'm having the time of my life in college. I've had such a big friend group in college. I'm going to parties. I'm going out. I'm drinking. I'm having the time of my life in college. So I wasn't down bad about this boy. You know what I mean? Like how I was in high school. So he calls me and I'm like, hey, what's up? He's like, hey, how you doing? I'm like, I'm good. So we just start talking. Like, we just start having normal conversation. And he's just like telling me what he's been up to. And he's like, yeah. He said, I've been texting our iMessage thread, just hoping that the messages, you know, popped up blue one day. I guess they did. And I'm like, yeah, like, you know, that's cool. So we're just talking. In my head, I'm like, I'm waiting for him to say, can you come over? Not because I wanted to come over, y'all, but because I wanted to test to see, can this boy actually have conversations with me outside of sex? Like, can he actually have conversations with me outside of us doing something sexual? And he did. Like, we didn't talk about sex at all. He didn't bring it up. He didn't tell me to come over. Everything was calm. Like, it was a calm conversation. We talked for like a cool like 30 minutes. And then I think either he or I had to get off the phone. And that was that. Like, you know, so let's fast forward. He will just do little check-ins. It will just be little times where I will call him and talk to him. It will be little times where he will call me and talk to me. But like, our conversations were never long. Like, it will only be like 5 to 10 minutes of us just catching up and stuff, and him talking and telling me what he got going on for the day. And you know, that would be that. So I'm not gonna lie, I begin to feel like, dang, like I wanna come over there. You know what I mean? Like, it wasn't so much like, and I told him that the day that he had unknown called me, I told him, when I wanna come see you, I'm gonna ask. Like, don't ask me, can you pull up, da da da. Like, don't do it. Like, cause I ain't doing it on your terms. Like, we're doing shit on my terms, buddy. We're doing shit on my terms, not your terms no more. We've been doing shit on your terms since high school, and I have gotten the short end of the stick every single time. So when I wanna pull up is when I'ma call you. I wanna call you is when I'ma call you. When I wanna answer the phone when you call me is when I'ma answer the phone when you call me. One day I called him and I'm like, hey, can I come over? And he was like, I don't know if you could come over. I'm getting a haircut. I can hear like the zzz in the background. So he's like, I'm getting a haircut right now. And after I get a haircut, I might go out with my boys. So I don't know if you could come over today. He's like, but I'm gonna look at my schedule and I'm gonna see when you could come over. Bitch, when he said schedule, bitch, I said, bitch, I said, bitch, am I talking to Chris Brown or Stanley? What schedule? Nigga, do you play for the NBA? What schedule? Mind y'all, I'm on the phone. I said schedule. He's like, yeah, like my schedule. I said, you got a schedule? You got a schedule? He's like, everybody got a schedule, Irene. You do too. I'm like, but you got one? Now, bitch, I know I got a schedule. I'm a bad. babe, I know I have a schedule. I'm a baddie. But why do you have one? So he's like, yeah, like, I gotta look at my schedule and I'm gonna let you know. So I'm like, all right, Stanley, like, I'm not finna beg, you know what I mean? I'm like, all right, just, you know, hit me up when you can. Okay. So that was that. So one day, mind you, I didn't hit him up no more throughout the week. He didn't hit me up. Like, I was just like, all right, that's cool. So one day, my friend, I don't remember where me and my friend went, but my friend lived on campus and I lived off of campus, and she didn't have a car at that time. So I ended up dropping her off at her apartment. Pull up to her apartments, and you guys, if y'all watch my channel, then you guys know for a given fact, what do I always say in all my videos? If I look at your license plates once, especially if I mess with you, if I look at your license plates once, that's it. Like, I'm gonna memorize it forever and ever. As long as I keep talking to you, I'm gonna memorize it. If we stop talking, I'm gonna forget it. But if I'm talking to you, I'm gonna always know your license plates. And that's not even just for guys. That's for my friends. That's for my family. Like, that's for some of my enemies. Like, I'll be remembering license plates, okay? So I remember when I went to Stanley's house in the beginning of the school year, I seen his car and I memorized his license plates. As I'm pulling into my friend's apartment, why do I see Stanley's car in front of my friend's building? So I'm just looking. I didn't say nothing to my friend. My friend knew that I was talking to him, but she didn't really know, like, the context of our relationship for real, because she was like, me and her, we still friends to this day, but at that time she was like my college friend, you know? So like, she didn't really know, like, the deep context of me and him. I never really told her everything. And I'm really just looking. I'm looking at his car. Like, I don't know, like, my spirit just did not sit right with his car being there. And I'm just looking. Like, y'all, when I tell you I did not move from that parking spot, I literally just sat there and just was staring at his car. It got to one point where I'm like, should I wait for him? But I'm like, why would I wait for him? Like, who knows when he's coming out? You know, but I just was so confused what his car was doing there. So, did I call him? Yes. What? Y'all are watching Irene. Y'all know I called him. He did not answer. He took the call. He rejected the call. I'm like, oh, okay, all right. I see how we playing. Like, I see how we doing. Texted him and I'm like, where are you? Like, I just asked him, mind you, when I texted him that, I left the apartment because I don't want, like, him to see my car and be like, oh my God, this girl is stalking me. Like, no, I'm not stalking you. Like, I dropped my friend off and your car is here. You know what I mean? I just want to know, where are you? Yes, I know they were single, because I know somebody in the comment section is going to be like, at the end of the day, y'all both single, so he could do what he wanted. You said that you were talking to other... I know, y'all. I know. But I still want to know, like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm still Curious George. Bitch, call me Curious George. I don't care. I never cared. I don't give a damn. I don't care. I'm always going to confront the situation. It don't matter whether we're talking or not. I don't care.
I don't give a fuck. Do I look like I give a fuck? Because I don't.
So, I'm like, where are you? So, he texts me back fast, too. He's like, hey, I can't talk right now. I'm at my friend's house. So, I'm like, okay. He didn't lie about being home, because I wanted to see if he was gonna say I'm home. Then I was gonna be like, oh, you doing something you ain't got no business doing. So I'm like, all right. And he's like, yeah, wow, what's up? I didn't say nothing. I just said, oh, nothing, I wanted to see you today. Like I said, we're single. I'm not gonna go say, like, what is your car doing out here, da da da. Like, had he lied to me, then yes, I would have hit him with that. But he didn't lie, so I'm like, shit, like, I can't do. But yeah, sorry y'all, my camera died. Your girl's camera died. But yeah, I'm like, I can't do nothing about this situation. Like, we're both single. Like, you know, I gotta keep it pushing. So, you know, I just chucked it up to the game. But I always kept that in the back of my head. Like, I always kept that in the back of my head. And it will be times, like I said, that I will go drop my friend off and his car will be there. And mind you, the times that I was dropping my friend's car off will be, like, at night. So I'm like, what's Stanley doing at this house? Like, what is Stanley doing here? Like, why is he always in this apartment complex at night? Like, it just gave weird. There were some times he would be there during the day, but for the most part, he was always at this apartment complex at night, and it was just giving weird. Mind y'all, let me pause this. While he was at the apartment complex at night, he would still do little call-ins and talk to me and stuff, and, you know, have little conversations with me. I remember one time when I was at the same friend's house, the one that I dropped off, he called me and we had little conversations. His car wasn't there that day. We had little conversations on the phone and stuff like that. But mind you, I never told him that I seen his car at the apartment complex. I never told him anything like that. I just always put it in the back of my head, right? So one day I called him to go to hang out with him. I wanted to hang out with him. Y'all gotta understand, outside of us dating, I still kind of liked him. Like, this is my high school. This is my high school man. You know what I mean? Like, this is somebody that I went to high school with and that I dealt with for so many years. I'm looking at it like this. Why are me and you on campus? We're on good terms. We talk on the phone with each other. Why haven't we seen each other? What's going on? You know what I mean? So I called him to hang out with him. I'm like, and mind you, we literally live so close to each other. So I'm like, hey, like, let's go somewhere, or let me come and see you. Like, what's up? Like, what's going on? He made up another excuse. This is when I was like, okay, something not right. Like, something going on, because this is not Stanley. Like, this is just not Stanley. Like, Stanley is not like this. Like, Stanley is not the type of person that dodges a hangout with me. Like, he's just not like that. Like, if I call Stanley and I'm like, hey, I need you here right now, like, that boy would drop everything and run. So to see him making excuses and talking about a schedule, like he was Tyler Perry filming for a new show and was busy or something, I don't know. Like, it was giving weird, and it was giving somebody new is in the picture, and it was giving somebody new was in the picture. Like, it was giving like a girlfriend was in the picture, not so much like a situationship, because I know that Stanley wasn't dodging me over a situationship or over a talking stage. It was giving Stanley had a girlfriend and he was trying to avoid me. This was my thing. If you have a girlfriend and you trying to avoid me, then nigga, avoid me. If I call, don't answer, and you don't call me. You know what I mean? Like, you can't do it halfway. You know what I'm saying? And I don't know that you have a girlfriend because you didn't tell me anything. I'm thinking this boy is single. You know what I mean? So I asked him one day, I'm like, what you got going on? And he texted me. He was like, what? And I'm like, yeah, like, what you got going on? Like, you obviously got a girlfriend. That's when I just started calling it out. And he was like, what are you talking about? I don't got no fucking girlfriend. He's like, you see, here you go. Like, here you go. You always starting mess. Here you go. Always starting mess. I'm like, yep. I'm starting mess. You got a girlfriend. I'm like, it's very obvious you got a girlfriend. And I was like, and if you got a girlfriend, you could have just said it instead of acting weird and shit. Stop calling my phone if you have a girlfriend. So you see, this is why I don't mess with you. He was like, so I got a girlfriend because I'm busy. He was like, the times that I want to see you, you didn't let me see you. But when you want to see me, we should do everything on your turn, on your time, huh? I'm like, yeah. Yeah, like, what? Like, we've been doing everything on your terms and your time for years, and we haven't gotten nowhere good. So yeah, we doing shit on my time. Like, what's the problem? Like, he just went off on me. Like, he just went off. Like, he was like, I'm delusional, I'm crazy, this is and that. And we just stopped texting. I'm like, okay, cool. Like, you have a girlfriend. I'm not finna argue with you about it. You have a girlfriend. Like, I just kept saying that over and over again in the text messages. And then I'm toxic. I went to go call him to argue with him. He was rejecting that call. Like, bitch, I didn't call. It said the number that you are calling is not available. I'm like, the number is definitely available, cause bitch, I'm messaging him and the messages are going through. So bitch, somebody better answer this phone ASAP, no rocket. So I'm like, the number available in Jesus' name. Oh, I'm like, all right, cool. You don't want to answer the phone. It's cool. I'm like, nigga, I know you. Like, you got a girlfriend. Like, it's simple. I said, yeah. So at this point, I'm like, all right. Like, I'm peeping everything, y'all. Like, everything is a buildup. And y'all have to understand one thing about me, where I'm trying so hard to learn how to not get it to that level no more. Because right now, I'm not really going to, like, get into details about it. But right now, there's this guy that I was dating that, like, we don't talk anymore, and it's been so hard for me to let go. Like, he called it off with me. I didn't call it off with him. He said he just wanted to be friends, but I was like, I don't want to be friends. So we just stopped talking in general, because I don't do that, oh, let's just be friends shit. Like, it's either we're dating or we're not dating. So I caught it off with him, but it's been hard for me to fully let go. You know what I mean? Like, it's been very hard. And I struggle with this. It's something that I struggle with. I've gotten way better over the years, but I still struggle with it. It's very hard for me to let go fully. Let me tell y'all something. When I let go, and I don't know what it is with me. It's like a switch that goes off in my head. When I let you go, you would never have me again. Never. And the reason why is because I'm the type of girl where I give so much grace. I give so many chances. And I know some people might be like, why are you giving grace and chances to guys who show... shut up. I'm telling y'all how I am. It's not good, but I'm just letting y'all know. Like, I give so many grace and so many chances. So when I get to the point where I'm fed up, you would never get me again. Never. Because it's like, damn, like, you just OD'd it. You know what I mean? So that's how I started to feel with Stanley. Like, I just started to feel like you just doing stuff. Like, I'm watching you. Like, I'm building stuff up and I'm watching your portfolio just build up higher and higher. Like, you just doing stuff. Okay, keep doing stuff. Because when I get to cutting people off, I don't want to hear nobody complaining. Back into no contact. We weren't talking. Went back into not talking to each other. I'm not gonna lie, I started to miss him. I'm not gonna lie. Like, I started to miss him throughout the no contact. So I end up calling him. Call him. And he answers and he's like, hey, what's up? And I'm like, nothing. Like, what you doing? I wasn't trying to go over there and see him. I just wanted to know what he was doing. I was like, what you doing? He was like, none. I'm in my bed. I'm chilling. And I'm like, all right. He's like, what about you? I think I had just left my friend's house. So I'm like, I just left my friend's house. And he's like, oh, okay. He's like, I'm surprised you called me. I'm like, why you say that? He's like, because you think I got a girlfriend. I said, you do have a girlfriend, but we ain't talking about that right now. He's like, all right. So, mind y'all, this is legit how me and Stanley used to talk, y'all. Like, legit. And like I told y'all, I never addressed the situation from the fight from the previous one. I always used to move forward like Toyota. Bitch, I used to move on forward like Toyota. So, I never used to address anything until, like, mad day. So, I'm like, we ain't talking about that right now. So, we just get to talking. Like, we're just talking. We're just catching up. You know, like, just having normal conversation. And he's telling me, he's like, I want to see you again. And I told him, I'm like, I'm not seeing you no time soon because you got a girlfriend, sir. And he, you know, he's getting mad. He's like, I don't have no girlfriend. I'm like, yes, you do. Like, I know you have a girlfriend. It's very obvious. And I'm not going to get in the middle of that. Like, how we were in high school when you had that girlfriend in high school and she was fighting with me over you. Like, nah, like, it's not going to be a repeat. Like, it's just not. So, yeah, like I said, I was just calling to check on you. And I told him straight up, I'm like, I'm not going to lie. I do miss you. I said, but I ain't coming nowhere near you. Like, I'm not coming nowhere near you. And he was like, all right, I see what you mean. And we end up getting off the phone, right? Fast forward to, this was a couple of months before COVID. I came to realization that me and Stanley never talked about our differences. I came to realization that ever since high school, we never addressed our issues. We just kept it pushing and acted like nothing happened. And that was one of the main reasons why we were always in conflict with each other. So he will still call here and there. I will call here and there. But there was one time that we got on the phone. I remember this. I was in my living room of my apartment. None of my roommates were home. And so I was just talking to him on the couch. And I was like, hey, Stanley. He's like, hey, yeah, like, what's up? I'm like, we've never discussed our issues. Like I said, since high school, I've never told you how I felt about anything. Here he come. I'm not finna do that. Bitch, I thought a dragon was talking to me. Bitch, I had to look at the phone. But then I remember that dragons are extinct. So who's talking to me? So I'm like he get yelling. He get the, not yelling, but like, y'all, his tone gets very deep. He's like, I'm not gonna do all that. Like, leave the past in the past. You always trying to discuss stuff. You see, that's the problem now. Like, I'm like, what? He's like, mind y'all, we never, y'all, when I say never, we never discussed any of the problems that we had in high school. Never. It was always just me confronting him about something and him denying it and me figuring out later on that he did it. and then I cut him off, I block him, he blows up my phone, and then we become cool again. And then he did something else. Like, it was always like that. It was we never sat down and discussed anything. So for him to get on the phone and be saying that I like starting mess, he just started saying, this is your problem. You like starting mess. You like doing this. You like doing that. Like, this is the reason why. This is what he ends up saying, y'all. This is what he ends up saying. This boy ends up saying something along the lines of, this is the reason why I only like having with you. Okay. Okay. I understand it now. I was like, okay. Cool. Cool, cool. So I'm just like, y'all, like, I don't even, like, even looking back at it, I don't know what to say about that. Like, what do you say to that? Like, and I told him, what did you say? He's like, yeah, I said it. I said, I don't care. I said it. He said, I tried over the years to like you. I try to like you. He said, you're a likable person, but you're not at the same time. Like, you just always start a mess. You're always starting mess. And I'm really looking at him like, I'm always starting mess. This is a nigga. And I'm not gonna sit up here and act innocent, y'all. I done did my dirt. I ain't gonna lie. So I'm not gonna act like I'm innocent, because I'm not. This is my thing. When me and Staley started dating, I was completely and utterly into Staley and Staley only. I didn't see no other guy. I didn't care about other guys. I'm talking about in high school, right? This is somebody who started dating me, and we're supposed to be getting ready to get in a relationship. And I find out behind my back, he goes behind my back and gets a girlfriend. I stop talking to him because I don't want to be the side chick. I stop talking to him. He sees that I don't want to talk to him no more. So he lies about the fact that he doesn't have a girlfriend. I start fucking with him again because I believe him. Girlfriend finds out about me. She confronts me. It starts a big old war in high school. Everybody is choosing sides and is picking and choosing who looks better. He's still sleeping with other girls around the campus. He sleeps with one girl on the staircase, ends up getting sent to alternative school. A week later, I get sent to alternative school, so they think it's me that he slept with on campus. Everybody is making fun of me for sleeping with a nigga on the staircase that I never slept with. Always different girls. There's girls that are befriending me, talking shit about how Staley looks, but is sleeping with him behind my back. It's been years of bullshit. It's been years of you doing weird shit. It's been so many years of all this bullshit that I have never really confronted. But I'm the problem. I'm the problem. The only thing that I did wrong was staying. That's it. No other girl would have stayed. No other smart girl would have stayed through the shit that I stayed with for you. And I get on the phone and I tell you for the first time in 6 years that I want to discuss everything that you have put me through. And now I'm the problem. And now this is the reason why you only like sleeping with me. I'm like, all right, cool. Like, I'm just beginning to peep him. And I'm like, okay, all right. Yeah. So I end up hanging up. I hung up because I'm like, nah, like, you just so disrespectful. Like, you so freaking disrespectful that you will blurt something like that out to me and think that I'm not gonna just spaz out on you. But instead of spazzing out, y'all, I just hung up. I just hung up on him. And he didn't call back. I didn't call back. And that was that. Like, you know, that was that. We're gonna stop the story time right here. I'm trying to think. That's what happened. Like, that's really what happened of this series is going to be how I ended up cutting Staley off. That's going to be the last part of this series. It's going to be how I ended up cutting off Staley, and it's going to give an opening to how I found out about his girlfriend, because he did have a girlfriend, y'all. Like, when I tell y'all, God don't play about me. God don't play about me, y'all. I don't think... God don't play about me. Like, when God tell me something, God tell me. Like, because I'm not going to lie, with the Legion series, I kept saying, God said. And throughout the series, I was seeing people saying stuff like, this girl be lying on God. This is... Stuff, like, comments like that. Like, trying to deny that I heard things from God. Babe, just because you don't believe in God or just because you don't believe that God speaks through us, that don't got nothing to do with me, okay? Like, Big G, not the little one, be telling me stuff. You know what I'm saying? And when I seen his car outside my friend's apartment building, God told me he had a girlfriend around that time. And he sure as hell did have a girlfriend. So the third part is going to be me discussing. Well, God didn't tell me he had a girlfriend in that moment, but God put in my spirit that something wasn't right about his car being in that apartment building. And then when I kept seeing it over and over again, that's when it clicked, like, oh, this boy has a girlfriend, because the car is out there. And then on top of that, not only is the car out there, he's going there at night and he's not hanging out with me as often. Like, everything is clicking. Ooh, hold on, y'all. Before we go, I knew I was leaving something out. That's why I didn't leave right away. Let me get to the zebra situation, because I know you guys are, some of y'all were asking me, how did you find out that he slept with your best friend? So this is how I found out. And I've said it before in the zebra series, but I know not everybody has watched my friendship fallout story times. So when zebra, let me refresh y'all's memory. Zebra was an old friend that I fell out with. Bozo was an old friend that I fell out with. I introduced Zebra and Bozo together. Them bitches turned their back on me and started talking shit about me. And I stopped talking to both of them. They were friends for like 2 years until they had their big falling out. As soon as they fell out with each other, they just started telling the business, y'all. They was going around telling everybody everything that each other said. Zebra was telling some of my friends shit that Bozo said about them. Bozo was doing the same thing. And then we found out that Zebra slept with one of our friends' man. And we also found out that Zebra went and slept with Bozo's man to get back at her. So this is how I looked at it. I'm like, well, if you slept with our other friend's man when y'all fell out, if you slept with Bozo's man when y'all fell out, then you slept with Zebra. 2 plus 2 is 4, not 5. So one time when I was talking to Bozo, because this is when like everything happened. This is when Bozo and Zebra fell out with each other and they were going off on each other. I ended up talking to Bozo at her house and I asked her, I said, did Zebra sleep with Stanley? And she literally just looked at me and she said, did she not? And I was like, what do you mean, did she not? She was like, you think Zebra didn't sleep with Stanley? And it just like that, y'all. And I was like, I want to know. I said, I don't have no proof. I said, I do think she did, but I don't have no proof. I said, the times that I was saying that she slept with Stanley, I didn't have no proof at all. And Zebra told me, yes, she did sleep with Stanley. Zebra also, not Zebra. Sorry, y'all. I'm confusing names. Bozo told me that Zebra slept with Stanley. Bozo also told me that one of my friends, she used to throw a game night at her house all the time. And Bozo was her roommate. Y'all remember, if you guys watch my story times, then you guys remember the story time of when my friend beat the hell out of Bozo's ass because she was being messy. They were roommates with each other. And my friend used to throw game nights at her house. So my friend invited Stanley and his friends to her house. And Zebra got invited too, just because, you know, she was friends with Bozo at the time. Tell me why Bozo told me that at the game night, Zebra grabbed his... Yeah, she grabbed it. She grabbed his, yeah. And she said that Zebra, after she grabbed his thing, Bozo said that Zebra went to her and said, Irene was right, he is big. So I'm just hearing this and I'm just disgusted. Like, y'all, when I tell you, and even, I would never not be disgusted in this shit, because it's like, why? Like, why are you doing that? I don't know why I keep mixing the names, y'all. When Bozo is telling me this, I'm just looking in disgust. I'm just looking at her like, I'm looking in disgust because I don't like Bozo, first of all, but I like the fact that Bozo was telling me the tea, you know, before we fell out for real. Because me and her fell out we never was friends again, but after my friend beat her ass, we really fell out because she kept going around telling everybody that I'm the reason why my friend fought her. No, my friend wanted to fight you because she wanted to fight you. It's that simple. My friend does not have, like, my friend has a mind of her own, you know? So she was telling me that, and I was just like, okay. And, you know, and that's why, like, you got to watch the certain friends that you tell, like, oh, he got money, or, like, because with our other friend that she slept with, his man, the man that she slept with, he had money. And that's why she slept with him, because she started trying to ask him for money afterwards. So, like, she was doing vindictive things based off of stuff that we told her about these guys. So, Bozo alleged that Zebra slept with him that same night that she grabbed his shit. And y'all know Stanley a dog. Like, he don't care. Stanley gonna take it if you give it to him, you know? So, I know for a given fact, Stanley did not care about how I felt or nothing. And that is the reason why Stanley was asking if me and her were cool. Stanley wanted to know if it was a green light for me, for him to go mess with her without me knowing about it. Because Stanley is not one of them guys that be in girl drama. Like, Stanley would never, like, when I remember how I used to be in fights in high school and shit, Stanley never asked me about any of that. The most he would say is, are you good? And I would tell him, yeah, I'm good. And that would be that. He would never say, oh, what happened today at school when we were in high school and I used to fight with other girls? He would never say, like, oh, what happened with such and such? Like, why'd y'all get into it? No. He would only be like, are you okay? And I'll be like, yeah, I'm okay. And we'll keep it pushing. So for him to ask me if I was cool with Zebra and then ask me why did we fall out was already a red flag to me. When Bozo was telling me all this, I was like, okay, like, I already suspected it, but it just confirmed it. So yeah, she slept with Stanley. I slept with Stanley. I ended up confronting her about it. She denied it, but she denied sleeping with our other friend's man. So there you have it. You know what I mean? Like, she did it. She was yelling on the phone because I told her, I said, I know you slept with Stanley. She told myself, no, I didn't. I'm looking at her like, bitch, you can huff puff and blow the house away. You did it. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you did it. Like, you slept with that boy. Your friend already said that you slept with that boy. So I don't know why you acting like you didn't sleep with that boy. And that's just how I told her, y'all. I'm like, girl, whatever, you slept with him. Like, and I said, you using pussy to get revenge, Zebra? And she's yelling, I didn't do it. I didn't do it. But mind you, she was yelling and screaming and saying she didn't do it with our other friend. And the boy that she slept with admitted to our friend that he messed with her and it was a mistake. So it's like, I just knew you were lying. Like, you slept with Stanley and that is trifling as hell. And for you to go up to Bozo and say Irene was right, his is big, is mind boggling. You know what I mean? Yeah. So I found that out too. Mind you, I found that out after me and him got into the argument on the phone that day and he yelled at me and stuff. So after I found those things out, I was just done with him. Like, I didn't want to sleep with him no more. Just over him. I wasn't even mad. I was just done. Like, I was done with him. Like, that's just how my mind was set up. Like, yeah, like, it's done. But I'm gonna be real, even though I was done with him, it wasn't the nail in the coffin. It just wasn't. Like, I was done with him, but my mind wasn't sure about it. You know when you're done with the boy. You know when you're done with the boy. And it don't matter even if, like, you know, you can say that you're done with a boy, but you could be done with him physically. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, everything's clicking for me now. I was done with Stanley in the physical realm. So I was done with Stanley as far as sleeping with him and communicating with him. But I wasn't done with him mentally. My energy was still with him. My mind was still set on him. But I was done with him physically. I knew that I would never sleep with him again. I knew that I would never speak to him again. Because I just kind of felt like, out of all people, why would you sleep with one of my best friends? This girl's used to be my best friend, and you know that this girl used to be my best friend. Why would you touch her? Like, you have no boundaries. And I knew I was done with him because I didn't even text that phone and confront him. That's how I knew I was done with him, because yeah, I was silent about it. You know what I mean? So, yeah, y'all, that's the story time. We're going to give you guys the part three. We're going to talk about finding out fully about his girlfriend and stuff like that. If you guys like this story, y'all, please be sure to give me a thumbs up. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much. Like I told y'all in the last story time, how many likes y'all give me will be based on how fast I push out part three to y'all. I'm trying to push these stories out to y'all, but y'all gotta help me. Buster Richie was talking about me when he made that song. Baby, can you help me? Bitch, help me. Y'all go ahead and like the video up. I love you guys so much. And y'all comment down below and let me know how y'all feel about this story time. Also, y'all let me know how y'all think I found out about the girlfriend. I love y'all.